Hello again, Izzy at Digital Goja Showrooms, and today we're going to take a look at the newest Fuji mirrorless. This is the Fujifilm X-T2. This is the kit with the 18-55 2.8 F4 RLM OIS. Whew, mouthful. Let's take a closer look at this beautiful mirrorless camera. If this helps you out, remember to hit me up with a like button underneath, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for future sessions, tutorials, and unboxings such as this, and to share with fellow photographers. And when in Miami, visit me at Digital Goja Showrooms. Now, this is their newest version in their APS mirrorless line. It's a 24.3 megapixel APS X-Trans CMOS version 3 sensor with the newest X Processor Pro engine. It has a beautiful electronic 2.36 million by 0.77 OLED viewfinder, and the screen now has a three-way tilting system. It's not a touchscreen though, but it does give you the capability of tilting it at different angles, so it's great for close-up shots or crowds or macros. Again, you can monitor it composing with the electronic viewfinder or the real LCD, depending on what you prefer. And again, it has that 0.77 magnification with that high resolution, so it gives you a nice crisp image. It allows you to have a clear view even with a refresh rate of 60 frames per second, which can bump up to 100 frames per second depending on the kind of action you're doing. It's a 3-inch, again, tilting LCD. Now this guy does internal 4K video with F-log gamma, and of course they enhance the recording capabilities because of the F-log gamma it provides. It gives you flat picture grading editing capabilities for later on. And of course, it also has HDMI output to support 8-bit 422 signal. So that even gives you almost like film simulation in your video capture. This guy gives you built-in Wi-Fi. So that means with the appropriate app, you can control your X-T2 or pass your images on to your favorite tablet or smartphone. It has a 325-point hybrid AF system, and they now incorporated a newer battery. This is their NPW126S. This version has a higher milliamp, and I think it has to do with the fact that, of course, now we're bumping it up all the way to full to Ultra HD video, the 4K. And again, I keep trying to touch it. It's not a touch screen, but nice bright screen. I mean, this guy is beautifully clear. Again, the fully articulating screen has a really nice feature. And now you have this when you're doing portrait shots or close-up macros. That's a fantastic feature that they added on here. Again, nice and movable, but it's not a touchscreen, but that's a really nice added benefit. And you have the automatic sensor that switches over to the viewfinder when you want to look through here. Incredibly fast focusing. I mean, this has that little focusing switch here, this little joystick design. This little guy allows you to move your focusing points at will. And this kit comes with the 18-55. This one is the lens that allows you to actually set your aperture here on the barrel if you choose to. So you still have a clickable ring here so you can set your f-stop. And you also have your image stabilization with full-time manual focus. So for your videographers that prefer doing your focusing manually, you can do so. And even if you want to tweak for still imaging. I like the fact that it has still that retro design where you can set your ISO, your shutter speed, even your exposure compensation, all on a quick advancement. I mean, it's not menu driven. There's a lot of us photographers that still prefer that. And remember, this is fully weather sealed, so the body is great for shooting in harsh environments. Remember, you also have the dual SD slot, and it actually works with UHS 2 cards and UHS 3, but only on one slot. And remember that this lens is not your typical kit lens. This is a very well constructed 18-55, again, with the image stabilization, and it starts out at 2.8, so it's rather fast. Being a variable aperture, it still does the job for you. It comes with the new NP26S battery and the wall charger, which does work with a cable. And I mean, there's a lot of companies that still do that, and I've understood the reason. Some of us prefer the plug-in wall wart. Their excuse is this way. It's true. You might run into travel situations where you won't be able to plug this in or you don't have enough room. This gives you the capability of extending it out. It is universal. It works from 100 to 240 volts, but this one is a USA product, so it does have the USA plug. Again, the 18 to 55 lens comes with its own proprietary lens hood, which is fully reversible so that you can carry it with you at all times and not misplace it. That's a great feature. I love that when they do that. And it works with a standard 58 millimeter diameter filter size so that you can go ahead and find some really popular UV, CPLs, and ND filters on the market. And of course, you get the Fuji legendary strap, which is very retro. Actually, they even give you a mounting attachment so that you don't damage the material on the sides here. And of course, the little pop-up flash that you just attach on. And of course, they now are getting into larger flashes, and more manufacturers are offering flashes for the X-T2. So again, if you're in the market for a new mirrorless APS-C camera that does high-speed shooting and also Ultra HD video, take a closer look at the Fuji X-T2, and also be on the lookout for my next video on this, which will go into the more popular asked questions about the Fuji X-T2. Happy shooting!